The problem, I think, that has happened is that getting to the airport is such a difficult problem for people. Taliban don't help, but also the sheer numbers of people trying to get to the airport. And some of them are going to the wrong places. So, for example, where we are, which is where the British are processing people, they've actually had hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of people who are actually meant to be going to the United States, not to the UK, but they've been coming here for a variety of reasons. One, it was they thought this was the right place to come. Others say that this was the address they were given, rather than another camp, which is actually a short distance away from here. Some say that when they got there, which was meant to be the American base, there was actually nobody there, so they came here anyway. And so the British soldiers, pretty much on their own, making their own decisions, because they know all the various bits of paperwork that people are meant to have, just let them in if they had the right paperwork to go to either the UK or the United States or to other European countries. So they've had to deal with that problem. Now, we understand they're making, you know, quite good progress on that, and they're able to stream it in some way that those coming to Britain and perhaps Europe will come to one section, and then the Americans, those people going to the United States, will go into another section, and then they will move to the airport to be processed by the Americans over there. There was a real breakdown yesterday because there just weren't any American officials here to oversee this. But anyway, it seems overnight that they've got that in place. But it is interesting, you know, you can't help but feel, certainly for the United States side, that with people all over the country, they're just never going to get to Kabul to get on a flight anytime soon. And I think it's fair to say that even for the British, who have people who are perhaps much smaller numbers and are relatively near to here, it's very difficult for them to get through. And of course, we are talking people who have absolute right to come to the United Kingdom, but have extended families as well who they're trying to get with them. Now, that is open to interpretation, and I think there's going to be they're going to show a fair amount of leeway in getting people through. But of course, within all of these crowds, there are people who will never be allowed to go through, and they have to be pushed back outside. So these are really difficult choices for all the soldiers, for the Foreign Office staff and the MOD staff who are here as well, that they have to deal with. And actually, you know, the real point is these are life and death choices. There's a lady we interviewed the other day. She was in a piece we put out a couple of days ago. Now, she is a lady with a four-year-old daughter whose husband's in the Taliban. And she's got beaten up, and she basically fled and has got here. British Major made a decision that whatever, she should go into the system. But she has no rights to come to the United Kingdom. And we know that she's still here. There's a big explosion. I have no idea what that is, but I should imagine there's all sorts of armaments around here. They're having to process her and make a decision as to whether she should go to a third-party country. She is just one example, because all of the British and American authorities said that particularly vulnerable people, like one woman with her child, aren't going to be kicked back outside, especially if they know that there's links to the Taliban in the family and they will know that she's here. But it's complicated because they don't really have a right to come to any of those countries. For example, with this lady, she said she'll go anywhere. And I think what will happen is that other countries will try to assist. The point is, it's about getting these people out of Afghanistan, and it is a long process, but there isn't much time left. And, you know, the Brits a few days ago were saying it's only days. Well, each day is getting nearer and nearer to whatever deadline that is.